on two. Easy versus easy. Just looking for really should be different cameras. I feel like adding me in the screen is kind of whack. YouTube deck.
One, go!
Just easy to handle. Damn, the tag in YouTube sucks. Top tier hater, low tier player. See if he can back up the work. I personally do not want to play against the DDD. Just like that would say, I do not like them. All that. It up here. It doesn't even bounce it back. That's kind of funny. Wow, it's so far kind of in the field. That might do it. Let me just grab the ledge. Yeah. And make it a back air. Please die. I am wrong every time. The weakest back air on the planet. Please die, bro. I'm not crazy. Jack gave a point to a little bit there, but that's fine. Down throw should be. Good DI on the down throw. Jack's brother, a long time ago, used to play DDD. So Jack's probably pretty used to a lot of the strangeness of these little back setups. Ooh, that was weird. He got hit, but he grabbed armor again. No jump. Where does jump go? Up throw will take it here. He holds his legs pretty well. Jarvis is gonna go Yoshi. Still looking for dirt. You're fine. A lot of the time. But so far, it's working out. Wamp's is Yoshi. His egg money move is way different. He's a lot slower. He's a lot more deliberate about his moves. So we'll see if that is a huge factor. Because I know Dragon goes heat about the moves. So far looking like Jarvis has the upper hand. I'd like to see maybe a floating air from Les under that. Airbox wants to hit. It makes it so that there's no technical requirement, there's no timing. The egg kills him there, jumps right in. It's a good counterplay for Jarvis with the egg there. Recognizing that the Knack Jack has been going low every time. Jack at the ledge a lot of times. Knack Jack is very comfortable with ledge dashing or to be on stage. And that could come back to bite him a lot. Especially against Yoshi, who's a pretty strong disjointed dude. That'll do it. He holds in on the last hit and then dies off the top. DJ's tail is really hard to DI as well because of all the different hitboxes. So, understandable that he would make a mistake at this point. Good spot though, really good spot though. More teleports, but again, we'll see that ledge play. That poor ledge play really comes back to bite him in the ass again. Brought the feedback a lot. It hits him a lot. Two straight hits. Oh, nice reflect. Two straight hits will lead us into a stock. Back throw. A throw will do it as well. Wow. That's a stupid throw. Con cancels the end. Egg calls out his teleport, but he can't get a full punish off of it. Good float at the end. It keeps giving him stage. Every time he gets these two defensive options, he keeps losing more and more and more stage. This is the tech as he double jumps in and locks himself in. So, Game 3, he bans... What are these bans? I'm so confused. He bans Green Hill Zone. Yeah. I don't know. I feel like Warrior Wars is really good for you in this matchup. I guess Egg Money thinks differently. F is definitely one of the best games, and easily the best game in this matchup. If he really relies on platforms to watch him, and Pikachu has the combo game, and the tools to watch ever touching the bear. Good bear. No jump. And good follow with the board master. Very, very strong. And get good follow. Up tilt, up air, up air. Ooh, he gets the read! I don't know if that was intentional. It didn't look intentional. But that was sweet. He floats to the end there. Yeah. Sometimes when he's just getting dragged across the stage, hit stun will close out of hit stun, which is usually not intentional. I'm not sure if it's a bug or a feature. Players like it all. Yeah, here we'll take it there. We've been pressured edge to ledge. Again, I don't want to be a broken record, but the ledge play of Knack Jack could be a lot stronger. Let's give a jump. Gave him a jump back. I think that was supposed to be a down. Up here, he doesn't need the DI. Oh! Okay. guess that works. Very similar to but Mewtwo's fair, just insanely good. Good reach, good range. I mean, good reach horizontally, good range vertically, and nice frame data on it too. Ben, Oreo, yeah. Those dream, but I really don't like these cards. I feel like the smaller stage benefits so much in Smash. Be able to control a lot more space against Mewtwo's incredible green. And he's already grabbed Jack and Ledge so many times that he's able to make the whole game Ledge play. Up air. Doesn't take it. He could have gotten a read on the egg, but the egg is kind of awkward to deal with because we see it so early. Back air to cover a roll in. Back throw, good DI, he's ready for it now. Maybe he makes a stuff with the down throw now. Yeah, up here, we'll take it now. Alright, so we need five.
Dylan, you play Nick in PM, I know.
Metal cavern. I think this is fine. It's pretty much just like empty to the platform.
One, go!
That doesn't make a lot of sense, because a lot of stages are just empty to the platforms. But this stage really operates like empty, and then it doesn't give Yoshi any combo options. There are two insane, and this platform is amazing unless he incorporates a lot of shield stops and shield drops, which I haven't seen before. Up air. Isn't able to clean it off though. Air won't take it. He's gonna downbeat. Again. Forward smash does cover the low edge. So you're playing Dylan, right? You're playing Dylan? Well, he's in melee right now. Alright, so 35% does take him on a C screen of a few moves, like fair, but nothing too crazy like that. Good little strings. I like these guys' use of really fast normals to keep tacking on damage when they know their opponent can't fight back. I think both characters do a really good job of it. Oh, that was great teleport. Down tilt, up air. Yeah. He does fastball through out of the armor. I think that was really smart. Jack with the shield buff with the input. Grab him? Yeah, he goes for the grab him. It's too slow. Air won't take it, but up air would have done it. He's getting caught and he's like awkward. He doesn't want to be doing it. Jarvis doing a really good job of racking on damage. I really like his ability to corner Luigi, and then abusing when his first movement options aren't as good. Because Luigi's dash game is not great, it's usually with his wave dash and his teleport shenanigans that allow him to really get superior positioning on the front board. And we've seen, again, Eggmoney over and over and over punishing Jack Wallace for this really poor punishment. Last stock, just thinking about it, I think that's a really good option. We're trying to eliminate some of the momentum that Jarvis has. They CC the down tilt forever, and I think Jarvis can recognize that. Back air, yeah, but doesn't do it in a good place so that he can't punish. Fair will take it off the top. Jarvis giving him some shit, that's some strategy. 66% is doable. A few hits, he will die. However, Nick Knack Jack has had some really good combos in this game. So we'll see if he's able to utilize one of the really strong combos and get a kill. Up tilt trades, I think we're fine with that at this point. Again, these trades are like okay for Mewtwo, but it seems that straight hit is gonna mess him up. The Goose Bomb killing him at the end.
Here to rescue you.
Hello.
The winner is Yoshi!